Brothers and sisters in Christ, welcome to this liturgy for Good Friday and the form we will take, Stations of the Cross. And the Stations of the Cross have been reworked to reflect the context in which we are now living. From the earliest of times, Christians flocked to the Holy Land to visit the places sanctified by the events in our Lord's earthly life. Especially popular was the pilgrimage along the path our Lord took on the first Good Friday. The path is also referred to as the Via Dolorosa. This pilgrimage was made with great devotion, the procession stopping or making stations for prayer and meditation at the various traditional points where special events took place. For those who were unable to visit the Holy Land, the custom arose throughout Europe of setting up replicas of the different incidents along the way of sorrow, so that the faithful could make spiritual pilgrimages. After long development, these little shrines became restricted to 14, and it is now customary to set them up along the walls of Christian churches. No official prayers have been ever prescribed for this devotion, whether in private or in public. As a result, this year, we will center our devotions around the issues and people most deeply affected because of the pandemic. It is only necessary that there be a movement from one station to another and that people meditate, however briefly, on each incident. As we mark each station along with the attendant theme, I invite you to pray and focus briefly as we submit all our love and concern to our God. Together, let us pray the act of contrition. O God, we love you with our whole heart and above all things, and are greatly sorry that we have offended you. May we never offend you anymore. O Lord, may we love you without ceasing and make it our delight to do in all things your most holy will. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends.
You are my friends if you do what I command you. For all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you.
For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life, that I may take it up again.
No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord.
I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This charge I have received from my Father.
Let us place ourselves in the presence of Almighty God and ask pardon for our sins. As we walk with Jesus Christ from the Praetorium of Pontius Pilate to the Tree of Calvary, we recall to mind the passion and death of our Lord and see the great love he has for us. Jesus, I meditate on the mystery of your passion and death to help me amend my life and to prepare myself to someday see you face to face. In the blood of the cross is my salvation. This journey prepares me for my personal crosses, especially at this time as we are called to live in the presence of the faceless enemy, COVID. First station, Jesus is condemned to death. All his public life he went from town to town doing good. But they said he was troublesome and had broken the law. His kindness, his healing, his miracles were not remembered. All the good he had done was forgotten. He was a threat to those in authority, so he had to die. False judgments pervaded that hour. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Then the high priest stood up and questioned Jesus. Have you no answer to the charge that these witnesses bring against you? But he kept his silence. He made no reply. Again, the high priest questioned him. Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One? Jesus said, I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of God and coming with the clouds of heaven. Then the high priest tore his robes and said, need we call further witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What is your opinion? Their judgment was unanimous that he was guilty and should be put to death. The kings of the earth rise up, and the princes conspire together against the Lord and against his anointed. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. The Lord said to me, You are my son. This day I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for an inheritance. The high priest stood up and questioned Jesus. As we contemplate on the action of this religious leader, let us remember all churches and their leadership during this time of the pandemic. We pray that the church continues to be an oasis of compassion and love, a place of care and warmth, a place not defined by a building, but a heart like yours, O Christ. Amen. Amen.
He came from his throne.
The second station, Jesus takes up his cross. The two pieces of wood were crude and rough. The cross was the way criminals were punished. Why did you accept the cross and start to carry it? This would have been a perfect time for a miracle. You had suffered enough already. During the night and early morning, you had been whipped, crowned with sharp thorns, and made fun of. People spat in your face, and all your friends left you. Nevertheless, Jesus, you took the wood of the cross, drew it close to your body, and started walking down the streets of Jerusalem. You viewed the cross as a great treasure, a special sign of your love. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. And Pilate said to the Jews, "Behold your king." But they cried out, "Away with him." Pilate said to them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priest answered, "We have no king but Caesar." And so they took Jesus and led him away, bearing the cross for himself. Jesus says, "Whoever does not bear his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple." The word of the cross is folly to those who are perishing, but to us who are to be saved, it is the power of God. As Jesus takes up this heavy beam, the political elite loses the willpower to do what is right. Let us present all political leaders in Canada and the world. We pray that as they make decisions in relation to the pandemic, that they might always make the correct ones for the betterment of all their people. We pray that no decision will ever be made from a desire for greed and selfishness. May the Lord's power work through our leaders for the common good of all.
Amen.
Amen. Third station, Jesus falls the first time. Jesus, you were exhausted and weak from carrying the cross. Your shoulders ached from the rough wood. Your back was tender from the painful scourging, and your head dotted with blood from the thorn bush crown. You fell to your knees. How cruel can people be? You created human beings to care for each other. You give love. We return hate. Could no one see the evil of what was happening? You arose and continued to show that your love is not just in words, but in actions. All your energy was spent on loving us. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Why is his clothing so red, like that of a man who tramples grapes to make wine? The Lord answers, "I have trampled the nations like grapes, and no one came to help me. I trampled them in my anger, and their blood has stained all my clothing. I decided that the time to save my people had come. It was time to punish their enemies. I was amazed when I looked and saw that there was no one to help me. But my anger made me strong. and I won the victory myself. Jesus, the minute we get tired in your service, we quit. The first time we fall, we give up. When someone makes fun of us, we stop doing good. How different we are from Christ. Jesus, without a word of complaint, you rose to your feet and continued the journey. We submit in these contemplations a few frontline workers, garbage collectors, nursing home providers. Many times you are forgotten. Lord, may we learn like these your people to get up and continue the journey even if a cross is on our backs. And maybe we can learn that the great glory of a Christian is rising every time we fall. Amen. Amen. The fourth station. Jesus meets his blessed mother. All of us want our loved ones to see us in good health, prosperous and well thought of. What an experience for Jesus to look up and see his mother as he passed by. As he looked at her, he could see the pain and grief in her eyes. He was passing by on the way to a criminal's death. Soldiers were making fun of him, and people along the roadside were looking at him in disgust. Why did his mother have to be there to see all of this? Mother and son looked at each other, and each could feel the sorrow in the other's heart. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world. Still burdened with his cross and wounded yet more by his fall, Jesus proceeds on his way. He is met by his mother. What a meeting that must have been. What a sort of anguish must have pierced that mother's bosom. What must have been the compassion of that son for his holy mother. To what can I compare you, O daughter of Jerusalem? What example can I show you for your comfort, virgins of Zion? For great as the sea is your distress, who can hear you? We remember all mothers who were affected from this pandemic. We especially remember those who had to bear the pain of burying their children this past year. What pain and grief were yours? We pray that others may listen as you share the wonderful stories of your children's life with the world. Amen. Amen.
The fifth station. Simon of Cyrene is compelled to carry the cross. Jesus, how tired and weak you were. They could see that you were not able to carry the cross much longer. You were slowing things down, and the soldiers had more enjoyable things to do that Friday afternoon. Then along came poor Simon. Perhaps he had walked down the wrong street and so ran into the procession, slowly moving toward Calvary. The soldiers grabbed him and forced him to carry the cross. The God-man was aided by an unwilling passerby. Oh, the mystery of being at a certain place at a certain time, and your whole life is changed. Simon, unwilling to touch the wood of the cross that would save him. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
As the strength of Jesus fails and he is unable to proceed, the executioners seize and compel Simon of Cyrene to carry his cross. The virtue of that cross changed his heart, and from being a compulsory task, it became a privilege and a joy.
With a loud voice, I cry out to the Lord. My complaint I pour out before him. Before him I lay bare my distress. When my spirit is faint within me, you know my path. In the way along which I walk, they have hidden a trap for me. I look to the right to see, but there is no one who pays me heed. I have lost all means of escape. There is no one who cares for my life.
Let us pause and remember the other among us, the poor, the destitute, those who were living paycheck to paycheck before this unseen enemy, and now no paycheck. We call to mind the prayer, Christ has no hands but our hands to do his work today. Let us go with haste to be that hand of love, to be the other among us.
Amen. Amen.
The sixth station. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. Those who have walked a great distance in the hot sun know how Jesus felt and looked. Where were the many people he had taught and cured along his public ministry? Except for his mother, a few women, and the Apostle John, everyone else was in hiding. But wait a moment. Out from the crowd stepped a woman. She offered her veil and wiped the blood and sweat off his face. The crowd teased and taunted her, but she was proud to do this small task for someone in so much pain and suffering. She did what God wanted her to do. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
As Jesus proceeds on his way, covered with the sweat of death, a woman, moved with compassion, makes her way through the crowd and wipes his face with a veil. As a reward for her piety, the impression of his sacred countenance is said to have been imprinted upon the veil. The righteous will then answer him, saying,
When, Lord, did we ever see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we ever see you sick or in prison and visit you? The king will reply, I tell you,
Whenever you did this for one of the least important of these my brothers, you did it for me. Lord Jesus, we say thanks. Thanks. Thanks to all the healthcare workers who held our loved ones' hands, who wiped their cheeks, who prayed, who smiled, who sang, and who spoke. They were our proxies. They were our legend, Veronica, as she wiped our Lord's face. We say thanks because they showed what it meant to be human as our loved ones transitioned from this life to the next.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The Spirit calls by love divine ordaining. The friends we need to serve and lead, the paths and gifts unchaining. The Spirit knows, the Spirit calls. Rejoice and make them welcome.
The seventh cross. Jesus falls a second time. Jesus, all the strength and endurance seem to have left your body, and you have fallen a second time. You needed to rest and have your wounds attended. But the soldiers start pulling at you and dragging you to your feet. You are goaded on by the cruel soldiery. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
But he endured the suffering that should have been ours, the pain that we should have borne. All the while, we thought that his suffering was punishment sent by God. But because of our sins, he was wounded, beaten because of the evil we did. We are healed by the punishment he suffered, made whole by the blows he received. All of us were like sheep that were lost, each of us going his own way. But the Lord made the punishment fall on him, the punishment all of us deserved.
Though he was harshly treated, he submitted and opened not his mouth. Like a lamb led to the slaughter, or a sheep before the shearers, he was silent and uttered no cry. When he was cut off from the land of the living and smitten for the sin of his people, a grave was assigned him among the wicked and a burial place with evildoers. Though he had done no wrong, nor spoken any falsehood.
Let us pray for those frontline workers who are carrying the cross for us all. We pause and remember supermarket workers and the people working in any service capacity, their managers, cashiers, and others. The lines are long, unruly, and impatient customers at all times challenge them. We ask for a spirit of kindness as these workers are strained. Lord, help us to lift them up by being cooperative so that they continue the journey.
Amen.
Amen.
Station. Jesus speaks to the women of Jerusalem. We all need friends, especially in times of difficulty and trouble. What a consoling feeling must have swept over Jesus when he saw this group of women concerned over his welfare. But instead of thinking of himself and his pain, his heart went out to them and their families. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When on his journey to Calvary, great numbers of people followed, many women among them, who mourned and lamented over him. Jesus turned to them and said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. No, weep for yourselves and your children.
Come, all you who pass by the way, look and see whether there is any suffering like my suffering, suffering which the Lord has afflicted on me on the days of his faith and wrath. All this I weep, my eyes run with tears. Far from me are all who console me. Far away are any who might revive me."
Friendship is seen. In this 21st century, let us be grateful for the medium of technology. Particularly, let us be grateful for Zoom, FaceTime, Facebook, Messenger, WhatsApp, and others. This faceless enemy robs so many friendships of intimacy. But technology bridges the gap and connects us all. We thank the Lord that we can still look upon each other. This is consoling. Amen.
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 Forbid it, Lord, that I should boast, save in the cross of Christ my God. All loving things that charm me most, I sacrifice them to his blood.
The ninth station. Jesus falls a third time. On this third fall, it was harder than ever to get up. Jesus, you would have loved to lie there and go in peace to your heavenly Father. But you stood up a third time and started the uphill march. Love reaches out. You overcome man's hatred with your love. We must resolve to rise every time we fall, to live instead of hate, to hope instead of despair. We must never let our sins and our weakness keep us from starting over again. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
It is of no concern to you who pass by. If only you would look and see, is there an agony like mine? Like these my torments with which the Lord has cruelly punished me in day of his anger? My transgressions were bound upon me, his own hand knotted around me. His yoke was lifted onto my neck, my strength failed beneath its weight. The Lord abandoned me to its hold, and I could not stand.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? When evildoers come at me to devour my flesh, my foes and my enemies themselves stumble and fall. Though an army encamp against me, my heart will not fear. Though war be waged upon me, even then will I trust.
Faced by age, comorbidities, other weight of pandemic seems all too much. Remember the most vulnerable currently, as they seek our comfort and help. We at this time remember all those who are near and dear to us, that we might walk with them and help them rise after falling again.
Amen. Amen.
Set you
10th station. Jesus is stripped of his garments. When they began tearing off your clothes, Jesus, they tried to shame you. The last of your meager earthly possessions were now gone. Then, fulfilling the words of the prophet, they drew lots for your clothes. That Friday afternoon, you were not a pleasant sight to see. But how beautiful you are to those who try to understand the depths of your love. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
As an expression of his human helplessness, as well as a sign of humiliation and means to intensifying his suffering, Jesus is stripped even of his clothes. Now he, the Holy of Holies, stands exposed to the vulgar gaze of the ruled and the scoffing multitude. Nevertheless, he was determined to reach Golgotha in the place of the skull. He is even more determined to die on the tree that his obedience may be perfect and our salvation complete.
I thank you, my Lord, for all the benefits you have given me, for all the pains and insults you have borne for me. May I know you more clearly, may I love you more dearly, may I follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen.
I thank you, my Lord, for the gift of your love to me. I thank you for the gift of human ingenuity in preparing vaccines. I thank you for all the scientists and nations across the world putting the gifts of vaccines in our arms. O most merciful Redeemer and friend, may I know you more clearly, may I love you more dearly, may I follow you as you show me yourself in others.
Amen. 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 In hoc acclaim, O gracious Lord, they snatched a purple cloak. Your passion turned for all they cared into
station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. It is hard to imagine nails being driven into a person's body, the senseless cruelty of it all. Jesus, you allowed your hands and feet to be nailed to the wood of the cross for love of me. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When they came to Golgotha, the place called the skull, they crucified Jesus and the robbers, one on his right, the other on his left. The nails are struck, the blood gushes forth, and Jesus says, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do."
Though he was harshly treated, he submitted and opened not his mouth. Like a lamb led to the slaughter, or a sheep before the shearers, he was silent and uttered no cry. When he was cut off from the land of the living and smitten for the sin of his people,
A grave was assigned him among the wicked, and a burial place with evildoers, though he had done no wrong, nor spoken any falsehood.
We call to mind students, especially those at a young age who are bursting with energy. During this year, the pandemic has lessened the space of energetic expressions. To many of them, they felt nailed to the cross. Lord, help them to see your love through administrators and teachers who still reach out to them.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
A sceptered reed, O patient Lord, be thrust into your hand, and act it out the grim charade to its appointed end. They did.
Station, Jesus dies on the cross. Jesus, you hung on the cross 3 or 4 feet off the ground, and you lost a great amount of blood through your open wounds. What pain and sorrow showed in your face. All your loving and caring had come to this. A criminal who hung by your side asked for forgiveness, and you told him, "This day you will be with me in paradise."
You seem to have failed. Teach me to find happiness in your will. Your tree of defeat has become a glorious victory. The gates of heaven are opened, allowing me to enter the joys of paradise. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
It was now about the sixth hour. There was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour, and the sun was darkened, and the curtain of the temple was torn in the middle. Jesus cried out with a loud voice and said, "It is finished. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Then, bowing his head, he died. O my people, what have I done to you? Or in what have I offended you? Answer me. What more should I have done and did not? I led you out of the land of Egypt, and you prepared a cross for me. I opened the Red Sea before you, and you opened my side with a sword. I gave you a royal scepter, and you have given me a crown of thorns. With great power I lifted you up, and you have hung me upon a cross. My people, what have I done to you? Or in what have I offended you? Answer me. We remember all who have died from the coronavirus, and many felt they did not deserve to die in such a manner. We pray, give rest, O Christ, to your servants, with where sorrow and pain are no more. Neither sign, but life everlasting. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servants Amy Rose, Joel Gibbard, George and Muriel Groom. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, sheep of your own fold, lambs of your own flock, sinners of your own redeeming. Receive them into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light.
Amen. Amen.
From the falter of breath, through the silence of death, to the wonder that's breaking beyond, God has woven a way unapparent by day for all those of whom heaven is for.
The 13th station. Jesus is taken down from the cross and laid in the arms of his mother. They took the nails out of Jesus' loving hands. His body is lifted gently from the cross. Mary received into her arms the body of her son, Jesus of Nazareth. What did Mary see? A baby born long ago in Bethlehem, a child and young man who grew up and worked in Nazareth, a man who walked from town to town preaching God's love, her son killed in Jerusalem and now resting against her body. Only a mother or father can fully experience the scene we now witness. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When the soldiers came to Jesus, they saw that he was already dead, so that they did not break his legs. But one of them opened his side with a sword, and immediately there came out blood and water. Joseph of Arimathea, because he was a disciple of Jesus, although a secret one for fear of the Jews, besought Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus, and Pilate gave him permission. Beloved Savior, you return to the Father all that he had given you, so that he might restore you 100-fold in the glorious resurrection. That is generosity at its best. We remember before you all police officers who are working the front lines in many dangerous situations. Give them the fortitude to continue the task.
Amen.
Amen.
Tis finished.
The 14th station, Jesus is laid in the tomb. The time had come for Jewish burial. Mary and members of the family washed away the stains of blood. Death and burial will close my career on this earth. However, I select my future judgment by the way I live each day. May my life be filled with kindness, mercy, and respect for others. I want to die a servant of the Lord. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Joseph of Arimathea took the body of Jesus and, wrapping it in a clean cloth, he laid it in his new tomb, which he had hewn out of rock. Then he rolled a large stone against the entrance of the tomb and departed.
Let your bearing towards one another arise out of your life in Christ Jesus. For the divine nature was his from the first, yet he did not think to snatch at equality with God, but made himself nothing, assuming the nature of a slave. Bearing the human likeness, he revealed in human shape. He humbled himself, and obedience accepted even death on the cross. We too, O God, will descend into the grave whenever it shall please you, as it shall please you, and wheresoever it shall please you. Suffer our sinful bodies to return to their parent dust, but in your great mercy receive our immortal souls. And when our bodies have risen again, place them likewise in your kingdom, that we may love and bless you forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Therefore, we proclaim our hope.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory.
Proclaim our faith. We believe in God above us, maker and sustainer of all life, of sun and moon, of water and earth, of male and female. We believe in God beside us, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, born of a woman, servant of the poor, tortured and nailed to a tree, a man of sorrows, he died forsaken. He descended into the earth to the place of death. On the third day he rose from the tomb. He ascended into heaven to be everywhere present, and his kingdom will come on earth. We believe in God within us, the Holy Spirit of Pentecostal fire, life-giving breath of the church, spirit of healing and forgiveness, source of resurrection and eternal life. Amen. Brothers and sisters in Christ, in these stations of the cross, we have been reminded once again of the extent of God's love for ourselves and for the world. We are aware that it is not only the divine love, but also the sins of the world which caused Christ to suffer and die and to rise again from the dead. Brothers and sisters, we also reflected upon the people and places and inventions brought on because of COVID-19. Let us therefore pray to God, our Heavenly Father, for strength to live up to our baptismal vow and promises in all the crosses that we are called to bear. Amen. Let us pray. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever.